Hi guys, Amy Bowman here. Today I'm out in my garden checking out my kale.
Well, I have two different varieties. I have this one, which is called dinosaur kale. It has a real bumpy texture, kind of like dinosaur skin. And then this one over here is called red Russian, has that purple stem running through it. About a month ago, the kale started to produce these long stalks that ended up in buds and flowers. And what this is called is bolting. And what bolting means is that instead of putting all the energy into the yummy kale leaves, it's now putting energy into reproduction. So we have these beautiful yellow flowers right here and those buds on the end. And these flowers will now be pollinated by all of our lovely pollinators. We have bees, I've seen bees, several different varieties, bumblebees and carpenter bees, honeybees all coming, and a lot of different other insects as well. And once these flowers have been pollinated, they will start to produce. If you see right here, we have a little bitty short stem. You can see where that flower was. This is the pistil of the flower that is now elongating, and it's going to become a seed pod. Here we have some that were pollinated probably a week or so ago, and see how long they are? All the different seeds are developing in there. Over the next few weeks, these flowers will all finish blooming and produce their seed pods, and the plant will start to die back, turn brown, and at that point I can cut them down and I can dry it out for a few days and harvest the kale seeds. Let's go over here to my red Russian, or my dinosaur kale. What you see here, you can see that we don't have any flowers on this anymore, and they're starting to die back a little bit, starting to get a little bit brown and dry out. And these should be ready in the next week or so for me to cut down, dry, and harvest the seeds. So when your kale bolts, all is not lost. It's a great opportunity to collect some seeds, and the pollinators just love these flowers. Thanks for watching.